Belinda Audio and Gail Books presents this unabridged recording of The Keane Edge, Mastering the Mindset for Real Lasting Fat Loss, written and read by Brian Keane. This book is dedicated to everyone in my inner circle. I love you all. Acknowledgements. There are so many people I would like to thank for supporting me in the writing of this book. Firstly, there are hundreds of podcast guests who helped me to expand my thinking and education around nutrition. Some have been mentioned directly in this audiobook. I want to thank Sarah, Rachel, and all the team at Gill Books. Sarah was instrumental in the shaping of this book. Rachel helped me to get it over the finish line, and the whole Gill team contributed to bringing it from concept to finished product. I also want to thank my family, my mother Rita, who has always been my biggest supporter, my father Jerry, who hardened my mindset to complete things regardless of how I felt, my sister Karen, who has supported my entire journey from day one, and of course, my daughter Holly, who gave my life new meaning in 2015. My thanks also to Paul Dermody, who helped me hone many of the nutritional philosophies in this audiobook and physical book, such as food relationships and not pressing the fucker button. To my friend and assistant, Gary O'Daly, who helped me to manage my workload during the writing of this book. To Orla O'Flaherty, who challenges me to see things from different perspectives. To Tricia Lewis, for introducing me to the team at Gill, the idea of resetting, and for being a constant inspiration to me. And to Serena Cabri, for being my rock throughout this entire process. She listened to every one of my rants or monologues when I was stuck writing a particular section. Thank you all. Introduction. Losing weight is a lot like baking a cake. Yes, you read that right. I'm starting this quote-unquote healthy eating book talking about baking a cake. As you'll see over the coming chapters, this book is unlike anything you've ever read before. I'm not going to be preaching the fat-burning capabilities of some random food found deep in the Amazon jungle or selling you on some quick-fix solution that massively reduces your calorie intake by eliminating an entire food group. Nope, you won't get that here. What you are going to get in the following pages is a mindset shift. You're likely going to hear some uncomfortable truths about the sole contributing factor as to why you don't look the way you want to look. I'll give you a clue. When it comes to every single diet or nutritional plan you followed unsuccessfully over the years, what has been the common denominator? Have you been too restrictive and pressed the fuck it button and binged on everything in sight? Possibly. Have you eliminated entire food groups in your desire to lose weight? For example, 6 weeks gluten-free or no dairy? Yeah, you might have. But none of those is the common denominator. Want to know what is? It's you. Yes, you. Or more accurately, your mindset and how you approach the diet or nutritional plan. But don't worry, we're going to fix that. But first, back to my cake. Surely cake is off limits if you're trying to lose weight or reduce your body fat. Well, yes and no. Yes, in the sense that in part one of the book, you'll see that calories do matter and food portion sizes are important. Eating a whole cake is unlikely to support your weight loss goal. Equally though, one slice a few times a week probably has the opposite effect. It gives you the psychological and metabolic boost you need to stick to your nutritional plan over the space of a week, month, or even a year. But that's not why I bring up cake. The reason I bring it up, apart from the fact that cake is delicious, is the baking element. If you've ever baked a cake or any other oven treat, you know that you have to follow a recipe. You need to do things in the right order, following a step-by-step process to end up with an appetizing baked good. But you also need the ingredient list. You get the flour and you have a pile of mush. You get the sugar and it tastes horrible. You get the eggs and it doesn't stick together. You get the idea. Developing the Keane Edge is exactly the same. To lose weight, you need the recipe and you need to follow a step-by-step process. In part one, we'll go through that. How calories work, what you need to know about macros, the foods that make up your calories and food choices, and the order of priority or fat loss pyramid of prioritization that comes alongside them. At this point, you might be thinking, oh God, not another diet book on clean eating, or to lose weight, consume fewer calories, been there, done that. Oh no, my friend, that's just the start of it. Similar to baking a cake, you can know exactly how to make it, but it still might taste like crap if you don't know what ingredients to use. Which brings me on to the meat and potatoes, pardon the pun, of this book. The ingredients, aka your mindset tools. The educational side of the weight loss process is broken down into everything from calories, macros, and food choices to using the correct metrics to track your progress. Randomly following dietary advice without context or knowledge is a recipe for misery. You might hit your weight loss goal, but you might not. You always want to be able to replicate what you do. For instance, if you lost 4 kilos to look your absolute best for a wedding or other event, you want to be able to replicate that anytime you need to in the future. I only use the word diet as an adjective. It's a skill you acquire to use when you need it. You diet to slim down for a date in the future. And unless you are morbidly obese or seriously overweight and you've been dieting for more than a year with no result, you're doing it wrong. Over the course of our journey together, you will acquire the dieting skill, but our primary focus will be on the nutrition side of things. That means finding a plan that is specific to your goal and then approaching it the right way. The ingredients come next, and the first one on that list is discipline. The discipline ingredient. When I say discipline, I'm not talking about grueling workout sessions in a gym, or even avoiding your favorite foods to hit a weight loss target. Far from it. What I mean by discipline is building habits that support your end goal, so you don't feel like you're on a quote-unquote diet. Being disciplined is about understanding how your daily actions and behaviors determine how well you do on your weight loss journey. If you tell me how you eat every day, I'll tell you how much weight you'll lose or how you'll look in a year. I'm also going to break down the myth of motivation and the misconception that there are quote-unquote motivated people out there. Spoiler alert, there's no such thing as motivated people. There are disciplined people, individuals with good daily habits, or people who have educated themselves and conditioned their mindset to find a nutritional plan that works for them. We can remove that unsupportive belief system of discipline here and now because it's nonsense and only serves as an obstacle to the correct mindset. More on this later. So if discipline is one of our ingredients, what else is there? I'm glad you asked. The failure ingredient. Failure is next on the list. Yes, failure is an important ingredient on your journey. But wait, how is failure helpful? Surely that's a bad thing, right? Nope. Failure is one of the most important ingredients on your weight loss journey because failure isn't final. Failure is feedback. Feedback on what hasn't worked in the past. Feedback on how you avoid self-sabotage in the future. In this section, we'll talk about the concept of pressing the fuck it button. You all know what I'm talking about. You've eaten poorly all day Saturday and then you had a big fry up on Sunday morning. So you say, fuck it, I'll start back on my plan tomorrow. Yeah, you know the button. If it's overused or worse, worn out, we'll figure out why and put a plan in place around it. Failure also gives us the tool of resetting, where you don't let one bad meal turn into two or a bad weekend turn into a bad week. We reset after a potential slip and we get right back on plan. That's failure as feedback. And that brings me on to the final ingredient in this recipe, the mindset tools. The mindset ingredient. This book is ultimately a toolbook. And your mindset tools are the most important ones. We'll go through philosophies such as getting your ladder up against the right wall, or in other words, finding the plan that's in alignment with your goals, one that includes foods you enjoy and one that you can stick to. We'll also go over the 0-1 principle on why the start of any new diet is the hardest part, even though it's usually when you're at your most motivated and why that's normally the problem. We will go deep on the problem with waiting for Monday if you're feeling motivated on Friday and the unsupportive behavior of having a last supper, a ritual that involves binging on your favorite foods because you start a diet tomorrow. We'll also go deep on your why. Why do you want to lose weight? Why do you want to reduce your body fat? Why do you want to look a certain way? Knowing why you're doing it can be the difference between success and failure on a dietary plan. You will come to see that it's not the diet that's the issue. It's your mindset towards it that's been the problem all along. The honest truth is that most diets work if you stick to them. But why can't you stick to your diet? Is it unsustainable? Does it eliminate your favorite foods? Do you feel rubbish on it? Low energy, crap sleep, poor sex drive? We'll uncover those tangibles and intangibles as we dive deeper into the book. But for now, realize that this book works with any diet. Although the final part will give you a nutritional plan to follow and some recipes with high quality, nutrient dense meals, truthfully, any plan will work if you stick to it. What tool do you need to help you with this job? Are you self-sabotaging? Cool, listen to that section and use the tools in there to help you. Do you lack motivation or have you bad dietary habits? Great, check out that chapter and pull out the tools you need. My mission with this book is to make you realize that outside of some fundamental educational principles that everybody on a weight loss journey should know, such as basic calorie intake, It's not the diet per se that determines your weight loss success. It's your mindset towards it that matters. Thinking that the diet is the problem, or what I call the quote-unquote diet mindset, is not only flawed, it's broken and downright wrong. And it's time to upgrade your thinking. You can leave that diet mindset at the door. Now we're moving to the next level. The level that gets you exactly where you need to be and keeps you there until your goals change. Now we're talking about the keen edge. How to listen to this book. Part one of this book is for absolute beginners. If this is the first book on nutrition that you've ever listened to, or are confused or don't fully understand calories, macros, or how food choices affect your body composition, then I recommend listening to part one in its entirety. If you are familiar with foundational nutritional principles such as calories and macros, you can skip to the end of part one, where I've recapped the main takeaways, and then jump into part two, which talks about developing the mindset around nutrition. Part three deals with nutrition itself and training, while part four looks at the pivotal but often misunderstood area of fat loss, sleep, and stress. The book's final part gives you the plan. It's not the unsustainable kind of one-and-done formula you may have come across in other diet books. I'm interested in mindset, nutrition, and how to efficiently lose weight or reduce body fat over time. That being said, the plan will help you get started if you're feeling motivated right now. That plan will be available as a download towards the end of the audiobook. Part 1. The basics. Calories 101. One of the biggest problems with most diet books is that they don't address the most fundamental thing when it comes to fat loss, the basic understanding of calories. Put simply, the amount of energy contained in an item of food or drink is measured in calories. When we eat and drink more calories than we use, our body stores the excess as body fat. If this continues, one tends to put on weight over time. It's not unlike a bank balance. If you earn €2,000 per month but spend €2,100 every month, you're going to be broke soon. Calories work in a similar manner. If your maintenance requires 2,000 kilocalories and you consistently eat 2,100 kilocalories, you're going to gain fat over time. It really is that simple and straightforward. As you'll see later, the types of calories you eat, or more accurately, the macro split or food choices you make, will affect how you look, how you feel, and your overall body composition. For now though, the takeaway message before we continue is that too many calories equals weight gain. How many calories do I actually need? Since too many calories equals weight gain, it begs the obvious follow-up question. How many calories do I actually need? Generally, the average man needs around 2,500 kilocalories a day to maintain a healthy body weight. And for an average woman, that figure is around 2,000 kilocalories a day. However, these are just ballpark numbers, as individual needs, current goals, activity level, and genetics all contribute to how many calories one should be consuming each day. I'm going to make the assumption that since you're listening to a nutrition book, your primary goal is weight or fat loss. I make this assumption because building lean muscle tissue or improving athletic performance normally require a different protocol for calorie calculation. If you have secondary goals outside of fat loss, it's worth factoring them into your overall calorie intake. For example, if you want to lose fat but also build lean muscle tissue or tone up, you might need to keep your calorie intake slightly higher than someone who is solely focused on weight loss. There are several ways to test and track how many calories you are consuming. And the key word here is test. A total daily energy expenditure, TDEE calculator, can be extremely useful for addressing the number of calories one needs to consume each day in order to lose weight, but it still needs to be tested. For those unfamiliar with a TDEE calculator, it provides an estimate of how many calories you burn per day, taking exercise into account. It is calculated by first figuring out your basic metabolic rate, and then multiplying that value by an activity multiplier. Simply put, it tells you how many calories you need to eat each day based on your lifestyle in order to lose fat. At the end of the day though, calorie calculators are machine-based and you're not a machine. You're a human being, which means that the way your body is physically responding is a better indicator of progress than any calorie calculator you can find either online or offline. However, These calculators do give you a good starting point. Just don't become too obsessed with the number. I mention this because I've worked in the past with people who are obsessed with their calorie intake. They look at the number on the calculator and track every morsel of food that they put into their mouth. From my experience, the understanding of basic calories is essential. But putting all your energy, effort, and self-worth into the numbers is a recipe for misery. I advise using a TDEE calculator to start tracking your calories for a couple of weeks to get a basic understanding of how many calories you are actually eating every day. After that, it's up to you whether you wish to continue tracking your intake rigorously or take a more lenient approach, such as gauging by eye the amount you were consuming. The one thing for fat loss. After you've calculated your TDEE, you need to get into a calorie deficit. Let's say your individual TDEE number shows up as 1800 kilocalories per day. This means that any number above this is a calorie surplus, which can potentially lead to fat gain. Conversely, any number below this is a calorie deficit, which can potentially lead to fat loss. I generally recommend testing your minimum effective dose, which in this scenario means you are focusing on consuming 1700 kilocalories every day, which means a deficit of 100 kilocalories per day. Test this out for 10 to 14 days, see if your body fat has reduced, and then based on that feedback, adjust or maintain your consumption accordingly. Of course, if you want more drastic results, you go into a more drastic deficit. But as part two of this book will explore, make sure you can stick to that deficit. Yes.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.